Big thanks to Simply Safe for sponsoring this episode. There's no safe like Simply Safe. Hi, I'm Coyote Peterson, and today I'm going to enter the Hagfish Slime Challenge. Ready? One, two, release the slime! Today's gonna be a zinger of an episode. We are headed out onto the Pacific Ocean to search for one of the most bizarre alien-like animals on the planet, the hagfish. And we're gonna answer three very important questions. Number one, what is a hagfish? Number two, do they bite? And number three, what happens when I cover myself in their extremely crazy and viscous slime? Stay tuned, guys. This episode is gonna get messy. To catch a hagfish, we have teamed up with world-renowned hagfish expert, Dr. Doug Fudge. He's a professor at Chapman University in Southern California, where he and his colleagues are testing a variety of hagfish slime applications.
This is a 5-gallon bucket that we've modified into a hagfish trap. It has these eel cones here. This is how the hagfish smell the bait and also enter the trap.
Also joining today's adventure is my good friend and biologist, Pat Spain. We baited the traps, threw them overboard, and then mounted a GoPro camera to a platform with a stinky fish head to see if we could capture behavioral shots of hagfish eating in the wild. I know what you're thinking. Is that really going to work? Well, I had my doubts too, but just wait till you see what we catch on camera. Trust me, it's freaky. With as much as I travel producing animal content, Simply Safe is the only home security system I trust to ensure that my home, my toys, and my dog Charlie are safe. Old school systems only trigger after someone breaks in, giving intruders time to grab valuables. But with Simply Safe Active Guard, monitoring agents react in real time to suspicious individuals approaching your home. They can see and speak to them, trigger alarms and spotlights, or even request police dispatch, all before a break-in ever happens. Simply Safe's AI tech can even identify trusted familiar faces, avoiding false alarms. If that's not enough, it's all wireless, so you can set up the best home security system of 2024 in just minutes. If you'd rather leave it to a professional though, Simply Safe does offer installation services. Unlike traditional home security systems, you'll never be locked into a long-term contract, so you can cancel at any time. Pricing is transparent and affordable, starting at less than $1 a day with no hidden fees ever. That's less than half the cost of traditional security systems. Save 60% on your Simply Safe security system when you sign up for a select professional monitoring plan and get your first month free. Visit simplysafe.com/bravewilderness to customize yours. There's no safe like Simply Safe. After the trap sat on the ocean floor for several hours, it was time to bring them up and see if we had any luck. Any hagfish gets this episode completed. We're so excited, so excited. One hagfish can make so much slime, we won't have any problem completing this episode.
100%, all we need is one.
Yeah.
Moment of truth.
Here we go, we're opening it up.
Oh yeah!
Oh! Woo! We got hagfish, ladies and gentlemen!
We got hagfish!
Yes! Yeah. We have hagfish, which means I'll definitely be entering the slime zone. So while we motor back in toward shore, check out the footage we got from the fish head cam. Deep down on the dark, freezing cold ocean floor, the camera caught something pretty amazing. Hagfish, drawn into the smell of fresh death, a behavior very rarely seen by human eyes. Okay, who's ready to make some slime? We are back from the field, but Pat, before we get into the entertainment, first we gotta learn a little something about these bizarre looking creatures. What in the world is a hagfish?
A hagfish is a primitive fish-like creature, one of the strangest animals on Earth, and really an alien.
But they do serve an incredibly important purpose.
They do, yeah. They're part of the cleanup crew of the benthic zone. So
okay.
The bottom of the ocean, when anything dead falls down to the bottom, they're one of the first on scene to start breaking that up, start eating it, and helping the process of decay.
How do they actually begin to scavenge.
Yeah, it's wild. They are a jawless fish, but they do have teeth, and their teeth are unique. They're made of keratin, like our fingernails.
Okay.
So when they grab a hold of something, their jaws aren't very strong. They're not gonna like rip through the skin of a whale, but they're gonna go into some of the holes that are already in it, either from decay or from some injury that thing sustained. They're gonna go into that carcass, and then they're gonna try to get a little purchase on it. Sometimes they'll tie themselves in a knot and pull their head through the knot to get a little bit of that.
Okay, so what everybody wants to know then is they are obviously capable of biting. The teeth sound horrific in their design and their function. Do they bite humans? What are the odds you think of them actually taking a bite on me? It sounds like they would take like a dime-sized nugget of flesh out from my hand if one latches on and...
I'm interested to find out.
Yeah, let's see what happens. You ready?
Oh yeah.
Okay, here we go. Coyote Peterson, and I'm about to enter the bite zone with the hagfish. Here we go. Ooh, the water's very cold. All right, hands in. Wow, I have worked with some animals that are slimy. This has gotta be the top slimy star. I'm just gonna real gently.
Wow.
Look at that.
Oh man. So what you're actually looking at here, that opening there,
yeah.
That's its nostril.
That's not its mouth?
No, it has one nostril that it's
where the heck is its mouth, Pat? I gotta put my finger in its mouth.
So the mouth is underneath that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Just see him kind of jump like that?
Ah!
Yeah. So that, the mouth is under that.
Okay, so go under that.
Yeah, so that's the nostril.
That's
oh, I
the see
mouth.
It.
You're going
I
right
see
to
it.
The mouth.
There's his mouth. All right, let's see. Are you gonna bite? Are you gonna bite? Oh, I don't think he's gonna bite. I can tickle his little mouth. Slime party is starting.
You don't smell like what their food sources are, luckily for us.
I would say the odds of actually taking a bite, even when tickling its bizarre looking little mouth, is not getting the job done, but I think it's a good opportunity for us to transition to the next piece of this episode, which is to get into the slime. All right, I'm gonna put this hagfish back down in here, and honestly, the most interesting thing that we are going to see today starts right there. These animals have an insane defensive ability. Would you grab our shark chompers?
Oh yeah.
You guys are gonna love this. So these are sharks. Let's talk about the hagfish's number one defensive tactic.
So imagine that you're a shark and you go down for a bite.
Dun, 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 dun. Got him.
Nope.
So that
exactly is the strategy that it would take. So they're not extruding the slime to prevent the shark from biting. They're doing it as a response to the bite. And what happens is exactly what you're seeing. It clogs up the shark's mouth and gills and makes it so the shark can't breathe.
I'm suffocating!
Yeah, theoretically, they could kill a shark with this. So when that shark does that initial bite,
mm-hmm.
when you grab that, it's super sharp, razor sharp teeth are only puncturing a bit of the hagfish's skin because its body moves around within this loose casing of skin. And because these guys can survive a real shark bite, we're not doing anything that's hurting them or doing anything that's bad for these fish. They are able to survive way, way, way more than this without really being fazed by it.
Look at this. This is exactly what Pat's talking about. I mean, this slime is incredibly viscous, and the fibers that are within the slime is what makes them sort of hold on to this rigidity.
Yeah, the slime is really unique. It's not like the stuff that you made as a kid out of glue. The slime is actually like 90-something percent seawater.
Okay.
But it's really, really thick and viscous and just completely unique to anything else in nature.
The hagfish has become world famous for its ability to produce slime. And though it might sound crazy, its most amazing talent is that a hagfish never runs out of slime. But how does the slime actually form? First, let's look at a cross-section of the hagfish. It has a pretty unique internal structure, and between the skin and the muscle are a series of around 160 glands. Within the glands are two kinds of cells. Mucus cells that produce the sticky goo, and thread cells that produce coiled fibers known as threads. When a hagfish feels threatened, the glands activate, releasing these threads, and the second they come into contact with ocean salt water, they unravel, creating a slimy expansion that is up to 10,000 times its original volume in less than half a second. This slimy expansion acts as a literal force field of protection around the hagfish, making it impossible for a predator to consume. When the danger is gone, the hagfish ties itself in a knot, works its body backward out of the slime force field, and voila! The animal escapes and goes about its day eating a rotten seafood buffet.
Okay, so now that we know they aren't going to bite, we know that their defense is slime, we've got to create the ultimate slime challenge. And to do that, we need a lot of slime. Let's go.
Whoa! Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, that is insane! All it takes, this is, oh my, wow. Wow, that is
you
instantaneous.
As the fibers mix with seawater, it's just forming this slime right in front of our eyes. If you saw this floating around, you'd think this was a jellyfish.
It does.
But this
look
all
like a
just
jellyfish.
Came from the hagfish.
And this is causing no harm to the animal in any way whatsoever.
Not at
right?
all. Not at all.
All right, so Pat, what I want to do next is get this goopy hagfish slime dropping onto my face. This should be fun. Okay guys, so we've made it to part three of today's episode, which is to answer the question, how sticky is the slime of a hagfish? And Pat, there's a crazy looking device behind me here. Explain this machine and what it's gonna do.
Chapman University has rigged up this slime drop apparatus. And this is used for different scientific experiments to show what happens when the slime falls at a rapid speed. And this is gonna simulate what would happen to a shark when it bites a hagfish. It's gonna get a huge face full of slime that's gonna gum up its gills and its mouth. And today it's gonna gum up Coyote.
So it is entering the slime zone, but it is simulating the suffocation zone, which is essentially what happens to a shark that interacts with a hagfish. So for this experiment, we're going hat off, we're going safety glasses on. That slime is gonna be falling faster than you would think, so I wanna take all safety precautions, and this is real science here, folks. So ready to enter the slime zone?
Absolutely.
Okay, here we go. Okay, this is it, the moment we have all been waiting for. Coyote Peterson entering the hagfish slime zone in slow motion from multiple different camera perspectives. So here we go. I'm Coyote Peterson, and I'm about to enter the slime zone with the hagfish. Safety goggles on. All right. Okay, one, two, release the slime! Whoa! I can see how if you were a tiger shark and you came in, it went up my nose. It's coming out my ears. It's so salty. I can imagine if you're a shark and this is in your mouth, you would completely get suffocated. Oh my gosh, it's so cold. It hit my face like a ton of bricks. That impact was insane. Okay, I'm gonna sit up so we can talk about this for a second.
That was a success.
I'm coming up. I'm gonna cut this camera. Yeah, okay, wow.
Yeah, well done.
Soaked, cool. Head to toe.
You got a little something on you. Let me get that for you.
Yeah, wow, wow. I mean, it was just like a rush of hagfish slime. The impact of that is obviously a little bit different than if you were to be a shark biting onto a hagfish, but man, I think what we could do is reset the slime mechanism, get a second shot. We're gonna actually cut my head in a little bit more to see if the slime will sit right there. Should we give it another go?
I'm down.
All right, slime challenge number two. Let's go for this. Wow, that was intense. All right, guys, we're getting ready for the second slime drop. We have now put in the maximum amount of literage that has ever been put in the cauldron to drop straight onto my face. All right, Pat, are you ready?
Oh yeah.
Okay, here we go. One, two, three. Release the slime. Oh my god! It's like covering my face! Oh, it's so salty, it's running into my nose! Oh man, that was insane. All right, I'm gonna sit up, Pat.
Yep.
Completely engulfed in the slime. This is crazy.
Yeah.
It is really difficult to breathe inside it. Yeah. I had to breathe out of the side of my mouth. So when I try to breathe in from inside of the right there.
How's that taste?
Oh, it's really salty.
You could see how easily you'd be able to suffocate with something
yeah,
like
yeah,
this.
Absolutely.
This is absolutely disgusting.
So you can see marine mammals can do a lot of what you've just did, clear your mouth.
Right.
If you were a shark or you were a fish that got this stuck in their mouth and gills, you don't have hands, you don't have flippers, you don't have anything that's gonna help you to be able to get that out.
And you would suffocate.
And you'd suffocate.
Wow, well, I have to say, this is an experiment that I never imagined that I would take on, but Pat, thank you so much for helping set this up, and a huge thanks to Chapman University and the incredible Dr. Doug Fudge for allowing me to enter the Hagfish Slime Challenge. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave, stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure. I think it's time to get the thumbnail.
We know you want to see that slow-mo slime drop in all its glory again, so here we go. Believe it or not, hagfish, like most marine animals, are under threat. And while no official organization is devoted to their plight just yet, Dr. Fudge and the students of Chapman University hope their research efforts lead to greater regulations and protections for this species in the future. If you are inspired to learn more or find yourself wanting to research these super slimers, please make sure to visit their website.
3, 2, 1, Hagfish!
Save 60% on your Simply Safe security system when you sign up for a select professional monitoring plan and get your first month free. Visit simplysafe.com/bravewilderness to customize yours. There's no safe like Simply Safe.